All right, so far we've seen a lot of short statements defining and manipulating data types and data structures. Now it's time for control flow, the syntax of telling your program which statements to execute when. For this module, you'll want to be following along in the playground file entitled L4 Control Flow. Let's start with for loops. Swift supports traditional C-style for loops like this one. Note that there are no parentheses around the condition. If you're used to C-style languages, you might miss the parentheses at first, but they'll soon fade from your heart and you'll realize you're better off without them. C-style for loops might work well for bar songs, but I think you'll really come to appreciate the efficiency of Swift's fast enumeration with for in loops, which you got a glimpse of earlier when we talked about strings. For in loops take the general form for, item in collection, and then between curly braces, the statements you want to execute on each item in the collection. To iterate through this string, for example, we just write for character in demostring.characters, which is a collection of characters, and then this print statement will be executed on every item in the collection, in this case, every character in the string. It's super convenient. And then here's what it prints to the console. Let's see another example. Let's find the sum of all the ints in this array. To do that, we just type for value in intarray, and this statement, adding int to the sum, will be executed for each member of the collection. You can see here in the playground sidebar that it's being executed 5 times. And then if we want to see our sum, we can just type sum, and that'll appear in the playground sidebar as well. We can use for in to iterate through dictionaries as well. Here we have a dictionary of movies and their directors, and here's a for loop that prints out a statement about who directed each of the movies in MovieDict. You can see that the syntax is similar to iterating through an array. In this case, the key value pair is placed in parentheses after for. And then both key and value can be referred to in the body of the loop. And if we want to see that output in the console, we just go down to the bottom of the screen and click on this button that shows the rectangle with the triangle inside. And here's the output we're looking for. But for the most part, we're going to stick to looking at our results in the playground sidebar. So let's close the console for now. Let's do one more. Let's try something with the animal groups dictionary. Here, the plural animal name is the key, and the animal group name is the value. And we can iterate through each pair to print out a statement about each group. So if we open up the console again, we can see that many whales form a pod, many lions form a pride, many geese form a flock. What do many eudacians form?